What's up, Rivalers, and welcome to the world's first Marvel Rivals tier list. After grinding the alpha for 10 hours straight, I'm here to tell you what the best and worst characters in the game are, so far. Please remember that the meta and my opinions on these characters are going to be changing. We are very early into the life cycle of this game, but without further ado, here is where every character places in the alpha. So let's start from the bottom tier. Now, don't get me wrong, every single character is fun in their own right, but these are the characters who are just a little harder to win with. Their value is a little less straightforward and sometimes a little more difficult. That is going to be Hulk, Black Panther, and Penny Parker. So it turns out that being a melee character and a hero shooter is kind of a disadvantage. Hulk is indeed great at creating space and diving backliners, but actually finishing off targets is very difficult. Black Panther most likely has one of the highest skill caps in the game, and his high mobility makes him a difficult target to land shots on, but he's basically an assassin that has to dive in, and the risk to reward ratio is just not great for him. I will admit that there's probably a skill issue here, but I had a much easier time finding kills as every other character. Penny Parker is an amazing zone control character with lots of spammable gadgets, but her skill set definitely just feels a little obtuse and a little weird. She's definitely the least straightforward character in the game, and I'm sure she'll find her place, but as of day one of the alpha, you will win more games on any other tank. Alright, moving up to C tier. These characters are a little more difficult to pop off on, but are either easier to pilot or bring more inherent value without being extremely good at them, compared to the D tier. Still not characters that you'll consistently win games on, but it's doable. Up first is Spider-Man. Now this is a 5-star difficulty character and easily has the most abilities in the game, so yeah, after one day people just aren't amazing at him. But he has some spectacular potential. I think by the end of the closed alpha we'll be seeing some really terrifying Spider-Man one tricks, but I would stay away from him until you've got a handle on the game. Spider-Man's mobility is even crazier than Black Panther's, the web-slinging potential lets you get in and out of fights, and his ultimate is pretty much a win team fight button, which is why he's placed above Black Panther. His ultimate is a game changer. The reason Spider-Man is still so low on the list is the same thing that will make people love playing the character, his complexity. His basic combo is web sling into right clicking to put a spider tracer on an enemy, then E-ing himself onto that enemy, knocking them airborne, and then getting in some auto attacks on them. And it's like, you could do all that, or you could just hold down left click on Scarlet Witch, which is 10 times easier. I'm going to be putting some serious hours into Spider-Man and really figuring out his place in the game, and I'll report back next time. Next, we've got Namor, who is really fun, but his lack of mobility really limits where he can go and what targets he can go after. He's much better on the maps with control points since he can just spam his turrets and set up base, but on the maps with moving carts, it's a little harder. Alright, up next is B tier. These characters are about average and come down to personal playstyle. They feel relatively powerful in certain matchups. We are extremely early in the game's lifecycle, so the general trend is that melee characters and high difficulty characters will have a harder time since we just haven't had enough time to learn their place. The simpler, the better, since nobody really knows how to play with or against most characters. Loki is another 5-star difficulty character, but he brings a lot more utility than the other ones because you can just blindly shoot into teamfights and you'll be healing allies, so that level of inherent usefulness is very strong in games like this. It's going to be a while before we see anyone truly master what this character is capable of, because there is so much potential with his clones and faking people out and repositioning tools, but right now it's pretty easy to just charge up your ultimate, duplicate the enemy Scarlet Witch or Punisher, and just mow enemies down. Up next is Doctor Strange, another character with insane potential. The portal is the ability with the highest potential in the game. I've already seen some really clutch portal flanks, and his right-click shield just gives everyone on your team a really obvious sign that says, "Stand behind me." Doctor Strange is your typical shield character, but with some added capabilities like being able to reposition with flying and a whole bunch of cool utility. It feels pretty useful to have a Doctor Strange on your team right now. And speaking of usefulness, up next is Storm. Now, Storm is a relatively easy champion that brings a lot of value to their team by passively boosting either damage or movement speed. And these types of turn it on and forget it auras are always useful when a game first comes out. To just constantly be getting a buff without having to aim or really position super well is just nice. So yeah, she's in B tier. Now, one thing I want to say about flying characters like Storm and Iron Man is that as people get better at the game, I think flyers are going to have to position really well to do what they want to do. I see a lot of players right now just flying 10 miles above their team, which basically just puts a neon sign on their head that says, "Hey, I'm an easy target." I scan characters which are characters that don't have travel time on their basic attacks, so things like Hela, Star-Lord, and Punisher, they're going to be really hard counters to these flyers. So by the end of the closed alpha, I imagine players that main flying characters are going to be much smarter about playing around corners and cover, but right now it doesn't feel like many players are punishing them, So they're going to be placed a little bit higher. So yeah, Storm is in B, and oh my god, that ultimate is so fun. Up next is Magneto, definitely a super cool character. He feels a little gated by having to land a lot of his auto attacks, and his attacks have travel time, so you really have to lead your shots, and in a game with this much mobility, that can be kind of hard. Magneto is a nice hybrid between offensive and defensive capabilities. He just can't quite compete with the best tank in the game, which we'll discuss later. He also has a shield, it's just not as good as Doctor Strange's. By the way, these characters are all really well designed. I spent 10 hours streaming the game yesterday and giving out alpha codes to our amazing community. And I wasn't bored playing a single character. They all feel like they bring something to the table, and even if you think you know how a character will play, they always have a little something extra that they bring to the table. So for instance, Mantis, I thought she was going to be a very straightforward healer type, but you actually will have to cycle through offensive and defensive capabilities, constantly building up your mana bar by shooting headshots, and then expending it to either power yourself up, heal your allies, or damage boost your allies, and it always felt like I was making a choice on which of those to do. I feel like people who play games like World of Warcraft and love cycling through lots of spells and juggling cooldowns will really like Mantis. This character felt surprisingly fun. Okay, let's move on to the higher levels. Now remember, all of this is subject to change. This is all based on my experience and in 10 hours of play, the trends that I saw. This game will evolve so much, even just over the next few days, but I wanted to give you guys a head start on what is winning games right now, and A-tier characters are winning a lot. So let's talk about Magic. Now, I talked earlier about how melee characters are kind of just harder to make work. Well, she's the exception to that rule. Her hitboxes on her attacks are very forgiving, her combos are a lot more straightforward, and as long as you're hitting something, you're getting a shield, so it's much easier to stay in messy fights compared to Black Panther or Spider-Man, who feel like they have to require a lot more precision and practice. Then we have Rocket Raccoon, who is another nice mix of offensive and utility capabilities. His Revive Beacon is an absolute game changer, and people don't really know how to prioritize finding and destroying it yet. So by having a Rocket Raccoon on your team, you're basically circumventing death timers, which is massive. Obviously, as people get better, they'll learn to go find and destroy the beacon. Rocket's healing isn't great though, and it can be difficult to heal some characters such as Flyers, since his heal is not hitscan. Next in A tier is Iron Man, who is very beginner friendly and great at just throwing bombs into teamfights, breaking shields, and of course that ultimate which wipes entire teams. Once again, Flyers just aren't really getting punished like they should yet, and I also found Iron Man is really good at taking down the enemy Flyers because his right click is a hitscan laser, so yeah, point and click and they fall out of the sky. He's great at spamming his basic attack blast into teamfights, which do nice AoE, and it's very noob friendly. Another noob friendly champion is the Punisher, who can set up a turret, and as people get better at the game, basically rooting yourself to use a turret is going to be less and less attractive, but right now, it is really funny to just mow people down, and oh my god, that ultimate has the highest DPS output in the game. It is insane. Punisher also has a shotgun and a machine gun, so he's a little more versatile than even the DPSs in S tier when you know how to swap weapons. And then we've got the best tank in the game, which is Groot. This guy has insane survivability, pretty decent offensive capabilities, and he's the one character that truly feels like a tank. He is constantly healing from his walls when enemies are damaged, and he can create walls, which no matter where you're at, means within half a second you could be behind cover. So yeah, this guy is really strong. Plus the Rocket slash Groot team up is one of the more straightforward team ups, so it's one of the ones that I see people getting the most out of on day one. Now let's talk about what we've all been waiting for. These are the best three characters in the game so far. Got Scarlet Witch. This character is so hilariously strong. You just hold down left click and constantly drain. You win every 1v1 because nobody is a god at aiming yet, and this attack aims for you. You also have two charges of your escape and repositioning tool, so in the rare case you're losing a duel, you can just opt out of it whenever you want. That ultimate is downright game-changing, and once again, people just don't respect it yet. I won so many games off of 5-man Scarlet Witch ults alone, and man, it just feels so good to use. Luna Snow is the most inherently useful character in the game. There's really not much more to say about it. I haven't played her much myself yet, but there is a direct correlation between the games that I won and the games that I had a Luna Snow on my team backing me up. Her ultimate is the biggest counter ult in the game, so basically you wait for the enemy teams to use a bunch of ults, you pop Luna ult, and yeah, your whole team is probably going to survive. It keeps them alive through so much burst, and she is the best pure healer for sure. Until a meta develops and people start playing around health packs, Luna Snow is the best way to basically give every one of your teammates 3 health bars. It's broken. And now, my favorite character in the game. I love playing Star-Lord. His mobility is insane, his hitscan auto attacks have way more range than you'd think, and his ultimate literally turns on auto aim, so you can pop that and just find the enemy healers and they die in less than a second, you've already won the teamfight. You can empty a full clip into your right click dash, which acts as a fast reload, which means you get another full clip, and then guess what? You can right click again, which gives you another full clip, and in the rare case that they survived all that, you can just press E to finish them off, which is this auto aim AoE ability. It looks super cool. This character is very strong and you will immediately notice if you're against a good Star-Lord or not. So there is our day one tier list. Of course, your experience may change, but I wanted to get this out there for those that are going to be joining the alpha in the next couple of days and want a head start on some easy, strong characters. Speaking of getting into the alpha, I'll be streaming the game right here on this channel again very soon with tons of alpha keys to give you. I had so much fun streaming with you guys yesterday. So make sure you are subscribed. I'm going to get back to playing this game because it is amazing, and I will see you Rivalers in the next video. Oh, wait. Stop the video. I forgot to place Hela. She's A tier.